Hey, what's up, guys? The Retro Toyscapades channel is back and hoping to keep you guys entertained during this quarantine period. Now, as of the time that this video is going out, the whole world is still pretty much on lockdown. And yes, that includes those of us here in Malaysia as well. But wherever you are, I hope that you guys are doing good and staying safe and sane. Okay, so today I wanted to talk about something that really caught my eye when I first saw it. This is Transformers vs. Terminator issue number 1. Actually, the exclusive variant cover by Malaysian artist Alan Kwa. Now, being that I'm a huge fan of 80s toys and pop culture properties, as evidenced on the output on this channel, now this was definitely something that was going to draw my attention. Now, I've not actually read the book yet. Has anybody out there checked it out? Leave a comment below, please, and let me know how it is. Okay, so this cover art from Malaysia's Alan Kwa, as I mentioned. Now, I'm not sure how many different covers were done for this series, but, you know, by usual variant cover standards, I'm guessing maybe 100? Actually, when I first saw this, I could have sworn that it was a cover from one of Dreamwave Productions' old Transformers books with Pat Lee. Remember those? Now, one thing about artist interpretations is that it's always great when the artist has their own unique take on the characters. Now, if I was looking at this cover anywhere, it pretty much comes off as the standard definition of what these characters would look like based off the animation cell for the cartoon. Optimus Prime and Megatron here look exactly like the way they do in the cartoon. Even the T-800 endoskeleton robot that you see here looks exactly like the one that you see in the movie. Okay, so when you think back to the 1980s at a time when the Transformers were first coming out, you had the toys, the cartoons, and then you had the comics. Now, the cartoon was taken as the main representation of these characters. And the toys, well, they actually look nothing like the cartoon. If you remember, yeah. But when it got to the comics, that's when it got really interesting. The Transformers comics of the 1980s were actually one of the longest-running toy-based comic book series of all time. And you had different books coming from the US and the UK with different creative teams. And there was a whole roster of artists ranging from people like, you know, you'd have Frank Springer to Jose Delbo, Andrew Wildman, Geoff Senior, among others. And let me tell you, if you are unfamiliar with the art that these guys were doing, well, not one single one of them had a similar art style to the other. All of the Transformers looked very different from the other. I mean, Jose Delbo's Optimus Prime and Geoff Senior's Optimus Prime were the same Prime in character, but looked entirely different on paper. But you could instantly recognize them when you saw them. It's like you knew which Prime belonged to which artist. Now, I kind of miss those days. It's like, okay, let me give you an example of an artist that has an individual imprint on the art that he creates. Let's say Rob Liefeld. You know who Rob Liefeld is, right? Now, if he ever did the Transformers. In fact, you know, he did do covers for a Transformers G.I. Joe crossover at one point. Now, Rob's work, regardless of whichever character that he works on, you know, he has such a distinctive quality that you would be able to recognize it instantly anywhere. It's like if he did a portrait of Optimus Prime. And let me tell you, man, if that portrait was on display on a store shelf and the store shelf was behind a heavily tinted window and you were seated at a cafe 5 kilometers away across the road and it was raining, you would still be able to recognize that portrait as being Rob Liefeld's Optimus Prime. Okay, now back to the cover. It's certainly very visually striking and energetic and busy, really busy. There's like 100 things going on here all over the place. But the one thing that struck me as a little bit strange is how, you know, you have the two main Transformers, Optimus Prime and Megatron, and they're seen here locked in combat as they always have been. It's like whenever there's Optimus, there's Megatron. Hey, we know this. Okay, Optimus sees Megatron. He's like, Megatron, one shall stand and one shall fall. And then they go at it. That's the way it's always been. But this is a Transformers versus Terminator crossover. So why aren't they fighting the story's most immediate threat, the Terminator? Now the Terminator here, the only one that you really see, appears to be fighting an invisible, unrelated enemy off-page. So both parties look for the most part like they're minding their own business. It's like, imagine if it was a Masters of the Universe and Transformers crossover. In fact, have they ever done that? I don't think so. Okay, anyway, it's a Masters of the Universe and Transformers crossover, and He-Man sees Megatron. And instead of fighting him, he's like, I don't really know who you are, so no. And then he goes off to look for Skeletor to fight again, because that's the enemy that he's most used to. To hell with the crossover. Now I know there's like these much smaller representations of the Terminators or Skynet's agents that you see cluttering around in the background, but you can't really tell what's going on here. So if you were to take a first glance at this, you know, it definitely kind of seems more like Terminator 2 Judgment Day the movie is playing on a TV in the background, while the Transformers slug it out as they always have. Now I'm not saying that this is a bad cover. In fact, what I really like is how the colors really pop. But I do think that it seems like a bit of a curious choice to have the characters presented in this way to show off the conflict in the crossover. But what do you guys think? You know, still, this is a very striking and highly detailed piece. And no doubt many of you will want a copy. It retails for something like $22 and is available at Mutant Beaver Comics. Now, is $22 expensive for a variant cover, or is it normal? I'm not sure, because I don't really buy a lot of new books. But let me know your thoughts on this as well. Anyway, there's a link below in the description if you wish to purchase a copy from Mutant Beaver Comics. Now, thanks for joining me as always, and do support the Retro Toy Escapades channel by subscribing. And I'll catch you guys again real soon. Thank you, and stay safe.